各位弟兄姐妹，大家早上好，平安。
Good morning, brothers and sisters. Shalom.
今天早上我们能够一起的来领受神的话语。
Let us all come forth today to receive God's words.
感谢主，哈利路亚。
Praise the Lord, amen.
我们要赞美他。
We will praise him.
我们要领受他的话语。
And we will receive his words.
Amen.
Amen.
因为他说他的话语就是灵，就是生命。
Because he said his words is the spirit and his words is life.
所以今天呢，我要跟大家分享的一个主题就是用心的聆听脉搏的这个的跳动。
So today, what I want to share with you is listen to the pulse with your heart.
那这个主题呢，什么叫做用心的来聆听脉搏的跳动呢？其实我们就要很专心，在这个时代里面，我们要聆听神要向我们说的话。
So what does it mean to listen to the pulse with your heart? It means that in this generation, in this period of time, we need to attentively listen for God's words.
今天呢，我要用的经文是在哈巴谷书。
Today, the scripture that we're using is in Habakkuk.
那我们先读三章的二节。
So we'll read chapter 3, verse 2 in King's James Version.
那这个呢，哈巴谷呢，它是它跟神的一个的祷告。
So this is a prayer from Habakkuk to God.
那我们来读它第二节，它面它只是一节的，我们先读一节的好不好？那我们先读啊，耶和华啊，我听见你的名声就惧怕。耶和华啊，求你在这些年间复兴你的作为，在这些年间显明出来，在发怒的时候以怜悯为念。
So this is the King James Version, yeah? So, O Lord, I have heard thy speech and was afraid. O Lord, revive thy work in the midst of the years. In the midst of the years, make known in wrath, remember mercy.
感谢主的话语。
Thank God for his words.
好不好？我们先我们的心来到归向神先，我们先做一个祷告好吗？
So let's align our hearts and return to the Lord as we pray.
如果我们在家里的，我们这个时候我们先安静我们的心来，一起的来向我们的神来祷告。
For those who are at home, let us all quiet down our hearts to pray to God.
我们向神说。
And we tell God.
是的，主，我们要聆听你的声音。
Yes, Lord, we want to hear your voice.
我们要聆听神啊，你在这个时代所要做的工作。
Lord, we want to listen to the works that you want to do within this period of time.
主啊，孩子们谦卑的来到领受今天你向我们说的话语。
Lord, our children will humble ourselves and listen to your word.
求圣灵来恩膏我们。
Let the Holy Spirit come upon us.
无论是恩膏我们讲的还是听的，我们要一同领受你的恩惠。
It doesn't matter if it's the one who speaks or the one who listens, God, we will receive your grace.
求圣灵与我们同在。
May the Holy Spirit be with us.
奉主耶稣基督的圣名祷告。
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
那我们看哈巴谷的这个的祷告，他向神来祷告。
So we look at the prayer of Habakkuk in this verse.
那在这一节里面呢，哈巴谷的祷告呢，其实他在心里面他表达了一种很深、很沉重的一种的情感。
So in this prayer, Habakkuk actually expressed a deep, heavy feeling residing in his heart.
而且呢，他的心呢，他的心情呢，也怎么样呢？也是带有很激动、很有力的一种的情感。
And he was very emotional, and he had a very powerful feeling within his prayer.
为什么？因为在整个的过程中呢，他的内心里面饱受着很多各种的这种的冲击。
Because throughout the entire process, his heart has received, he took in all the impact of things happening around him.
他心里面有疑惑，他也有征战，就是挣扎。
And there's doubt and there's struggles within him.
所以为什么？因为我们看到，如果在前面的一章和二章里面，他跟神的一种的对话的过程中呢，他深刻的领受到呢什么呢？他领受到神的在这个的领受到他的心意和他的计划。
Why? Because in the process of talking to God in the previous chapter, chapter 1 and chapter 2, he wholeheartedly felt and received God's wills and his plan.
虽然呢，他心情呢，他有很沉重的情感，很有一点，有一点的消极。
Though he felt very heavy in his heart, and it's a little bit negative.
但是呢，他也有很激动的情感，他也有积极的一面。
But it was also a mixture of strong positive emotions.
沉重是因为呢，他有疑惑，他有挣扎。
heavy because of doubts and struggles.
激动啊，是因为他明白神在这个时代里面他的心意和他的计划。
But he was emotional and positive because he understood God's plan and will.
各位弟兄姐妹，今天呢，我们是处在一个怎么样的时代呢？
Brothers and sisters, what kind of generation do we exist in today?
我们处在这个时代，其实我们内心也是非常的沉重，我们也有挣扎，我们也有很多的困疑惑。
Living in this generation, our hearts are heavy with struggles and doubts.
我们有很多外在的这种的冲击。
There are all the external forces that impact us.
我们也有内心里面的很多的冲击。
And there's even internally where we have our own impact.
我们看到外在的这种严重的疫情，我们生命会受到威胁。
And the external, like the pandemic, where our lives are at stake.
我们会常常听到身边哦，谁谁谁，我们的身边又有人确诊了。
And we always hear and receive news that of confirmed cases happening around us.
然后经济呢也是很大的冲击，带来前所未有的影响。
There's the impact of finance, something that we've never experienced before.
我们还看到在我们马来西亚加上那种政治上的冲击。
And in Malaysia, there's the impact of political news.
我们心里面我们很痛，我们好像流血一样，我们的心。
And our hearts ache as if it's bleeding.
我们看到这些的政客的嘴脸，他们只是为自己的权力来玩弄手段。
And we see politicians fight for their own power.
他们不管人民的生死，那种死活，我们看到了，我们心里面很痛。
They seemingly ignore the lives of their people, and it aches our heart to see that.
最近我又听到。 几天前我又看到新闻了，安华就是又给人家在搞他。
And recently, Anwar has been attacked and accused again.
告他的人就是他前他的前助理的跟他玩这个的基奸。
And it was accusing him of him and his ex-helpers doing the dirty deeds.
这是要争首相的时候，偏偏这个时候就出现了。你说这么巧吗？
Why is it during this time that's so crucial that it happened?
有没有更糟糕？已经。 还不够吗？还有公义吗？各位弟兄姐妹
，Is it not worse enough? Isn't this enough? Is that justice?
所以我们看到了这一帮人呢，他们只是在玩弄这种种族主义，还有宗教的主义，他们在玩弄情绪。
And these people, they play around with racism and the roles of religion.
人民已经在水深火热中啊。
And while the people are living in a life of that situation.
所以我们看到哈巴谷呢，他的祷告呢，他是很沉重，但是他转向激动。
And Habakkuk, you see, his prayer became from heavy to emotional.
他从那种很消沉的那种呢，他转向积极。
And he was able to turn from negativity to positivity.
因为他看到，因为神告诉他幕后的计划。
Because God told him the plans of the end time.
所以各位弟兄姐妹，今天我们也要明白神的心意和他的计划。
So today, brothers and sisters, we need to understand God's plan and will.
我们要从消沉，我们要转向积极。
We need to turn our negativity to positivity.
我们要从眼前这眼前这种的处境呢，我们要转向信心的把握。
We need to change our perspective from the things around us to our faith.
所以哈巴谷他说：“耶和华，我听见你的名声就惧怕。”
And Habakkuk said, "O Lord, I have heard thy speech and was afraid."
这个名声就是言语的意思。
And this heard is sharp.
Sorry. 名声就是言语的意思, speech.
The speech means God's words or God's voice.
所以你看他听见这个听见你的名声是什么意思？就是呢, shama就是很认真的听，用心的听。
So what does it mean by he heard God's words? It means heard as in shama, which means to listen attentively.
各位弟兄姐妹，今天呢，我们也要很用心的听，很认真的去听神的话语。
But this is today we need to listen attentively to God's words.
哈巴谷听见什么呢？我听见了，听见什么呢？
So what Habakkuk say? I've heard it. Heard. What did he hear?
他听见呢，这个的声音就是这个名声。这里翻译是名，但是新译本是声音或者是原意。
And in King James Version, it says thy speech, but in NIV, it's God's voice and God's words.
所以呢，我听见了，我听见你的言语，我听见你的声音。
And Habakkuk said, I've heard it. I've heard thy speech and words.
意思说呢，我用心的听见了你的这个脉。 那个脉搏的这种的跳动，你的心跳，神啊。
It means I've heard it. I hear your voice and your words. I hear the pulse of your heart.
然后呢，他产生什么？他说我心里就惧怕了。
And he felt afraid, and he was afraid.
这个惧怕就是他心里产生敬畏了，有种对神的敬意啊。
And this afraid is that he had a fear of God with respect.
为什么？因为他说我明白了，我心里面就产生了对你的敬畏。
Because he understood, and therefore I fear with respect.
因为呢，你向我启示了你在幕后的这个的计划。
Because Lord's plans have been revealed to him.
然后呢，他接下来的祷告说：“耶和华，求你在这个年间呢，来到复兴你的作为，在这年间呢，显明出来，在发怒的时候以怜悯为念。”
And then his prayer continues: "O Lord, revive thy work in the midst of years. In the midst of years, make known in wrath, remember mercy."
这个年间呢，就是我们的时代的意思。
And this midst of years means our years, our generation.
这个年间是我们的时代，你要显明出来，你要复兴你的作为。
And it means to show His work in our years, in our generations.
复兴你的作为，到底这个在讲什么意思呢？
So what does it mean by reviving thy work?
在这里的意思，它是复兴的意思，就有炼净，还有保存的意思。
To revival, it means to refine and preserve.
各位弟兄姐妹，我们常常的为我们的教，为这个世界来祷告，为我们的国家来祷告，我们求复兴，复兴教会，复兴我们的国家。
Brethren, we ask God for revival in our church and in our country.
但是在这里呢，神告诉我们呢，这个哈巴谷是告诉我们，这个复兴先要炼进神的家开始。But
here it says that to receive revival, we must first refine the house of God.
你知道炼进呢，就好像炼金一样，很多的渣子呢，它是不要的，它要被丢弃的。And
through the process of refining, the scums will be thrown away.
炼金呢，是要用火来炼金，来试炼的。And
to refine means it has to go through fire.
所以那个复兴里面的带有是炼净，但是好消息是什么？神同时神也要保守。And
through the process of reviving and refining, the good news is God will preserve His people.
神要保守属于他的子民。God
will preserve His people.
使到他的子民呢，在这个过程里面要脱离他们的罪，谦卑的来悔改，回到神的心意。To
let His people separate from sin and humbly repent before God.
能够与他来到对齐，这个就是复兴。
And they turn their hearts to align with Him. This is revival.
有时不一定是罪恶，有时候是我们来侍奉神，我们要侍奉两个神。
Or sometimes it's not even about sin. Sometimes it's about worshiping two gods.
所以我们求神复兴啊，复兴说神就是这样子，要从他的家开始的。
And God says, when we ask for revival, God says He'll refine starting from His house.
所以他讲最后那句，他说：“你在发怒的时候，以怜悯为念啊，主啊。”
And the last sentence it says, "In wrath, remember mercy, God."
就是当你在施行你的公义惩罚的时候啊，你要记得你的子民存有恩典啊。
And God, in wrath, as you do justice and punishment, please show mercy to your people.
为什么哈巴谷会这样子的祷告呢？各位弟兄姐妹。
Why would Habakkuk pray like this?
我们要回到一章和二章，哈巴谷对神的与神的那个对话，我们才明白。
We have to return to the book, chapter 1 and chapter 2, to understand how Habakkuk has his conversation with God.
所以呢，我们回到一章和二章那边，我们来看。So
let's look at chapter 1 and chapter 2.
你看，第二点呢，就是呢，他向神来求问。And
the second point is he cries out to God.
他向神求问哈巴谷呢，他问。
And Habakkuk asked his first question to God.
你看他一章的二节到四节。
In chapter 1, verse 2 to 4.
他说：“耶和华，我呼求你，你不应允。要到几时呢？我因强暴求你，你还不拯救。”第三节，你为何使我看见罪孽？你为何看着奸恶而不理呢？毁灭和强暴在我面前，又起了争端和相斗的事。因此呢，律法放松，公理也不显明，恶人围困义人，所以公理呢显然颠倒。
So this is the NIV version. How long, Lord, must I call for help, but you do not listen, or cry out to you, violence, but you do not save? Why do you make me look at injustice? Why do you tolerate wrongdoing? Destruction and violence are before me. There is strife and conflict abounds. Therefore, the law is paralyzed and justice never prevails. The wicked hem in the righteous so that justice is perverted.
为什么哈巴谷会向神来求来问问题呢？
Why would Habakkuk ask? Why would Habakkuk question God?
因为他挣扎，他有疑惑，他问神。
Because he struggled and he doubts, so he asked God.
所以他问为什么？为什么？
Why God?
神啊，为什么你不停止这个国家的罪恶？
Why didn't you stop the country from sinning?
就是他的自己的国家，就是犹大。
Which is his own country, Judah.
神啊，你为什么不拯救？你为什么不理呢？
Why do you not save? Why do you not care?
他跟神说：“你看，神啊，你看这个的律法律了，已经放松了，到处都有不公不义的事啊。”
Because the country's law is paralyzed and just injustice is happening everywhere.
这些的公义了颠倒了，恶人在掌权，恶人当道啊。
The truth has been turned upside down and the evil is reigning. The evil took charge.
然后义人在受苦啊。
While those of justice are suffering.
然后呢，毁灭和强暴在我们的面前啊。
Destruction and violence are happening right before him.
所以哈巴谷呢，他一连串的向神问了，为什么？为什么？
And Habakkuk questioned God with a series of why.
为什么恶人会兴旺？为什么义人会受苦？
Why are the evil prospering and why are the righteous suffering?
为什么神你不理会，不审判这样大的罪恶吗？
God, why do you not care? Why do you not let judgment fall upon these great sins?
你知道神怎么样回答呢？
And you know how God answered?
神的回答不是在哈巴谷的意料之中的。
His reply is not expected from Habakkuk.
不是他心中所期望的。
It is not an answer that Habakkuk wants.
你看神的回答对他说， 第一个的回答对他说，
And God's first answer to him was
在五节和六节那边，
In verse 5 and 6，
神的回答说他会兴起加勒底，就是巴比伦人来惩罚他们。
And God said he would rise up the Babylonians to punish them，
更糟糕，
Which is even worse.
他看到他自己国家这样子，他现在神还要使用那些外邦的那个巴比伦很残暴的人来惩罚他们，是更糟糕。
Habakkuk sees the state that his country is in, and now God wants to raise out those of the Babylonians to come and punish them.
所以你看五节和六节，我读给大家听。
And so here's verse 5 and 6.
所以耶和华说，你们要向列国中观看，大大的惊奇，因为在你们的时候，我行一件事，虽有人告诉你们，你们总是不信。我必兴起加勒底人，就是那残忍暴躁之民，通行遍地，占据那不属于自己的住处。
Look at the nations and watch and be utterly amazed, for I am going to do something in your days that you would not believe, even if you were told. I am raising up the Babylonians, that ruthless and impetuous people who sweep across the whole earth to seize dwellings not their own.
这些人是什么样的人？是残暴的人。
These people are brutal.
他们是有占领的野心。
They have the wild hearts of colonization.
他们呢？ 就是没有道德，他们要夺取别人的东西，他们很骄傲的知道。
And they're prideful and they steal from other people.
他们自以为意。
And they deem themselves righteous.
他们能够自恃高气扬，他们轻视别的人。
And they hold their noses up high as they look down on other people.
他们把自己的势力当作神。
And they treat themselves like God.
或者把他们所做的当作是神的代表。
Or they claim themselves as the representatives of God.
如果你是哈巴谷，你会怎么样呢？
If you were Habakkuk, what would you do?
怎么可以这样子呢，神？
How can this happen?
这完全不能够接受，对吗？
This is unacceptable.
根本是不能接受的。
It's so unacceptable.
就好像今天我们也是一样。
And just like today, it's the same.
今天我们都这样子的来祷告。
Today we pray like this.
我们常常为我们的国家来祷告。
We pray for our country.
神啊！ 我不知道你有没有这样子的祷告，神啊，求你来阻止马来西亚的不公不义。
I'm not sure if you prayed like this, like, God, please stop the injustice happening in Malaysia.
有吗？
Have you?
我们每天都这样子祷告, 对吗?
We pray like this every day.
还有, 我们求你挪走那些没有料的那种的 那种的政客, 对吗?
And we ask God to remove those incompetent politicians.
你认为神会怎么样回答呢?
What do you expect of God's answer?
我们常常这样子祷告, 你认为神会怎么样回答呢?
We always pray like this, so what do you think God would answer?
神说, 我会聆听你的祷告。
And God said, I will listen to your prayers.
我会。
I will.
我会给一帮更加愚蠢骄傲的人来做政府。
And I'll let even more stupider people and prideful people to be the government.
哈, 哪里可以这样子, 神?
What? How can you do this?
完全不在我们的预料之中。
This is so unexpected to us.
我们的祷告不是要改变这个国家吗?
Did we not pray for God to change the country?
神啊, 我们越祷告啊, 疫情越严重越糟糕, 政府越糟糕, 怎么可以这样子呢?
I mean, we pray for the better country, but instead, you know, the pandemic gets worse and the government gets worse.
我们是全马的教, 我们都一直没有停止为我们的马来西亚来祷告。
You know, all Malaysian churches has never stopped praying for Malaysia.
我们在40天禁食祷告里面，这个祷告呢，已经是推行了20多年了。
In our 40 days fast and prayer, this has been going on for 20 years.
我们也看到曾经有改变，曾经有改变，感谢主，但是现在又变得越来越更糟糕。
And yes, we've seen change, praise the Lord, but yet it has turned worse again.
各位弟兄姐妹，请问你心里面有没有困惑呢？
But sisters, are you very confused?
我相信很多人心里面也很困惑, 对吗?
I believe most of us would be very, very confused.
我们来思考。
And let us think.
请问各位弟兄姐妹,
Brothers and sisters,
我们是否常常对上帝的计划感到困惑呢?
Are we often confused with God's plan?
为什么这么多不公不义的事呢?
Why does justice keep, injustice keep happening?
各位弟兄姐妹，为什么我们很困惑，对吗？很多人都很困惑。
And we're really confused. We're lost.
最近我们看到阿富汗人民那种的绝望。
And again, recently we've seen the despair of the people in Afghanistan.
这些人民他们不想回到20多年前塔利班的那个时代。
They do not wish to return to the generation of Taliban that existed like 20 years ago.
你看到他们宁愿要挤上那个已经挤到爆的那个的。 那个飞机是没有再回家的飞机。
They would rather they would rather squeeze into the plane of no return.
女人呢，她们不想再回到好像过去好像连动物都不如的时代。
And the women do not want to return to a generation where they were treated like animals.
你家里有女儿13、14岁呢，你就要嫁给他们塔利班的人。
Those who have daughters would have to marry them off to the Talibans.
基督徒呢，面对生命的威胁。And
many Christians are facing life threats.
我看到呢，我们心里面都心都很沉重。
Seeing it, it heaves our heart.
我们也是很困惑。We're
really confused.
但是我们要再问一个问题，各位弟兄姐妹。
But we have to ask ourselves another question.
我们在这种极度困惑的时候, 我们如何来看待神呢?
In so much utter confusion, how should we see God?
我们如何看待他的工作呢?
How should we treat his work?
各位弟兄姐妹, 我们会怀疑吗?
Will we doubt God? Will we question God?
我们会失去信心吗?
Will we lose our faith?
还有, 我再问, 我们在这种极度困惑的时候，我们如何看待我们自己的生命呢？
And similarly, in utter confusion, how should we see our lives?
我们看到我们的未来吗，各位弟兄姐妹？
Can we see our own future?
你会再看到你在基督里面那个的身份地位吗？
Can you see yourself still standing in the identity of Christ?
你会看到在幕后的荣耀的未来吗？
Can you see the glory that has yet to come?
在这种患难中，在这种的这么坏的光景中，各位弟兄姐妹，
in calamity, in such difficult times,
也决定了你的选择，你知道吗？
It also shows your decision.
你可以选择自暴自弃，放逐你自己。
You can choose to self-destruct.
觉得这些都不关我自己的事啊，我只要看眼前的这些眼前。 享乐就可以了。
To choose to be unconcerned about the things happening around us and just focus on enjoying the present.
还是我们要仍然抱着选择来仍然抱着我们对神有信心呢？
Or should you choose to carry hope and faith in God?
我们是否对神仍然有这种盼望和信心呢？各位弟兄姐妹
，Do you still have hope and faith in God?
这个是今天呢，每个基督徒都要很诚实，要问自己的面对的一个的问题。
These are the questions that all Christians would have to face truthfully.
各位弟兄姐妹
，Brothers and sisters,
神看重的是什么呢
？What does God value?
难道神看重的就是这个？这些的巴比伦吗
？Do you think God values the Babylonians?
神看重的是他的子民。
No, God values His people.
所以复兴呢，要经过火一样的试炼。
And therefore, revival is refined through the flames.
但是同时呢，在这种过程里面，神也要保守他的子民。
But at the same time, during this process, God will protect His people.
所以呢，他就。哈巴谷就明白，他说：“耶和华，求你在我们这个时代复兴你的作为，在我们这个时代显明出来，在你发怒的时候以怜悯为念。”
And Habakkuk understood. That's why he prayed, "O Lord, revive Thy work in the midst of years. In the midst of years, make known. In wrath, remember mercy."
Amen.
Amen.
然后哈巴谷呢，他第二个问题来问神的。
And Habakkuk has a second question for God.
神啊，你怎么会用这种邪恶的加勒底人呢？
Dear Lord, why would you use the wicked Babylonians?
从第十二节一直到第十七节，他都在问神。
In verse 12 to verse 17, he kept asking God.
哈巴谷在那边呼求，为什么？为什么会让恶人来惩罚我们？
He kept asking why. Why do you use the wicked ones to punish us?
为什么叫那些不公不义的来吞灭我们？
Why do you ask those of injustice to devour us?
为什么你静默不出声呢？
Why do you stay silent and not speak?
所以你看十二节和十三节，我们来看。
And in verse 12 to 13, let's look.
他说：“耶和华我的神啊，我的身子啊，你不是从亘古而有的吗？你眼目清洁，不看邪僻，不看奸恶，行诡诈的，你为何看着不理呢？恶人吞灭自己公义的，你为何静默不语呢？”
Lord, are you not from the everlasting? My God, my Holy One, you will never die. You, Lord, have appointed them to execute judgment. You, my rock, have ordained them to punish. Your eyes are too pure to look on evil. You cannot tolerate wrongdoings. Why then do you tolerate the treacherous? Why are you silent while the wicked ones swallow up those more righteous than themselves?
各位弟兄姐妹，他在问神，哈巴谷在问神。
But sister Habakkuk is questioning God.
他说：“神啊，你是公义的，你是圣洁，你怎么样可以使用那些不圣洁的这些恶人呢？”
God, you are a holy God. How can a holy God use the unholy, wicked ones?
所以他不明白为什么。
He couldn't understand.
但是呢，我们要注意哈巴谷的态度是怎么样的态度呢
？But we must pay attention to Habakkuk's attitude.
这个态度就是关键，就是一个的关键。
And this is a key. His attitude is key.
虽然他不明白神你是圣洁的，为什么你会使用邪恶的人呢
？Though he didn't understand, he doesn't understand why a holy God would use wicked ones.
但是的态度怎么样？你看二章一节那边他讲。
But in his in chapter 2 verse 1, you listen to what Habakkuk says.
他就说：“我要站在这个哨岗，立在城楼。”留心看耶和华在我里面说什么，怎么样使我回复自己的愿恕。
I will stand at my watch and station myself on the ramparts. I will look to see what he will say to me and what answer I am to give this complaint.
这里在告诉我们他的一个的态度很重要。
This is the attitude of Habakkuk, and it's very important.
哨岗和城楼呢，就是在当时就是高的一个。比较高的搭起来的一个高地方，是要监视人的那些的动静的。
So to stand at my watch and the ramparts actually means to be at a high place to watch the movements of others.
在那个城楼里面呢，它是最高的。它要为什么？它要为了要 保护他自己的同胞呢？发现有敌人来了，他就要发出警报，来到告诉他的同胞了，这个的地方来的。
So to stand watch on the rampart is to watch out for the safety of their own kind, and to send warnings and sound alarms for if something is coming.
所以呢，哈巴谷呢，他虽然呢，他内心里面仍然有这种的矛盾、有挣扎、有困惑。
And although in Habakkuk's heart there's like contradictions and struggles and confusion.
但是呢，这里表示他的态度是谦卑的、忠心的，做一位的守望者，就是一个代祷者。
But his attitude shows that he is humble and he is a loyal watchman, an intercessor.
他虽然不明白什么，但是他虽然不明白，他虽然有很极度的困惑。
Although he didn't understand why and he was in utter confusion.
但是关键是什么呢
？But what's the key？
他不是来质疑一种不信对神的态度。
He was not questioning God without faith。
他是留意神的回答。
He rather listens for God's answer。
他要留意神的回答是为了什么
？And why does he listen for God's answers？
他是要为了神的子民。
And it is for God's people。
他要告诉知道，让神的子民也明白神的这个的计划。
He wants the people of God to understand God's work。
在未来的前景里面，神要回答他，深信神一定会回答的。
And in the future, God would respond. God will respond to His will.
感谢主，我们有这样子的人。
Praise God that we have someone like this.
在这个时代里面，神还是兴起这样子为他的教会、为他的子民、为他的国度来代祷的人。
And God, and even in this generation, God would continue to raise intercessors for us.
但是我们要问一个问题。
But we have to ask a question.
请问我们可以质疑神吗
？Can we question God?
我们不明白了，我们可以质疑神吗
？If we don't understand, can we question God?
关键是什么呢？
What is the key?
关键我们在信心之下的那种的怀疑，还有你在不信之下的怀疑是很大的一个的分别。
We question God with faith and questioning God without faith has two very different things.
所以呢，这个就是态度决定了一切。
And this is why attitude determines everything.
今天呢，我们也同样面对很多的困境，在这个时代。
And today we still face a lot of struggles in this generation.
我们很多时候我们真的不明白神的计划。
Many times we don't understand God's plans.
但是关键是什么？很多基督徒今天他们也离开了神，很多基督徒也离开了神。
But what's more crucial is that a lot of Christians has left God.
他们离开神是因为他们在不信之下的那种的怀疑。
And it is because they lost faith when they questioned God.
当他们不明白的时候，他是站在真的高处里面，他在审判圣经，他在审判神。
And when they don't understand, they stand at the highest point to judge the Bible and God.
很简单，就是说，神啊，为什么你在这个人间受苦啊？
Very simple question, God, why would you let the human suffer?
如果你存在，为什么你要这样子做啊？
If you exist, why would all the bad things happen?
容许这些不公不义啊
！Why do you allow these injustice things to happen？
我曾经有讲过
，And I've said before，
在美国有很多很多很有名的基督徒，他们也离开神。
In America, there are a lot of very famous Christians that actually left God.
他们都是领袖
，And they were leaders.
他们都是有影响力的
，They were people of influence.
曾经有一位他说：“我不能够接受神，为什么你是爱，为什么你要给人下地狱
？”And one even said, "God, if you are love, if you are of love, why would you let people go to hell?"
所以他离开了神。
And that's why he left God.
他是站在圣经，他是站在圣经上面来审判圣经，来审判神。
He stood above Bible and above God to judge them.
对，我们会有疑惑，我们会有怀疑。
Yes, we will have confusions, we'll have doubts.
但是我们要在服在圣经和神的权柄之下，我们来到谦卑的来问神。
But we need to surrender and submit ourselves underneath, to God and the Bible while we question God.
结果是很大的不同 ，Amen.
And it brings two different results.
所以哈巴谷就给我们学习到一个很重要的经，在今天这个末世的时代。
And during this period of time, Habakkuk has taught us a very good lesson.
神要复兴的时候, 他要炼净,
and because when God revives, there is refine. But at the same time, He'll preserve.
Amen.
Amen.
所以我们看神怎么样回答的第二个 问题.
So let's look at how God answers him the second time.
在第二节和第三节,
in chapter 2, verse 2 to 3.
当然他的回答, 神的回答是整个二节到二十节都是他的回, 但是我们只读二节和三节。
God's answer actually continues to verse 20, but we'll just look at verse 2 to 3.
但是他说, 他对我说, 将这末世明明地写在板上, 使读的人容易读, 因为这末世有一定的乐趣，快要应验，并不虚谎。虽然迟延，还要等候，因为必然临到，不再延，不再迟延。
Write down the revelation and make it plain on the tablets, so that a herald may run with it. For the revelation awaits an appointed time. It speaks of the end and will not prove false. Though it linger, wait for it. It will certainly come and will not delay.
神告诉哈巴谷什么你知道吗?
What did God tell Habakkuk?
当他告诉哈巴谷的时候，哈巴谷他要哈巴谷写在那个石板上。
God told Habakkuk and he wanted him to write it down on the tablets.
而且呢，要人家明白，容易的读。
And he wanted people to understand, the herald to run with it.
随时随地的都让人家知道。
To let anyone know at any time, anywhere.
到底他在讲什么呢?
What exactly is he saying?
神其实要告诉他，这个巴比伦啊，他在主前539年啊，他灭亡的一个的信息来的。
And this, because this is a message that God told him, Babylon will perish in BC
539.
In the future 50 years or 70 years, the wicked will also perish. The wicked will also perish. Though you see now, you see the period of time where the wicked seems to have flourished. In the end, they will still perish. They will receive judgment from God, and that's final. And what God has planned will come. What God has planned will happen.
Amen.
Amen.
弟兄姐妹,
brothers and sisters,
有人说, 我们人生呢, 在世上只是几十年。
And some say, you know, life on earth is only a few decades.
所以你要看谁的命长了，对吧？
And we need to see, you know, we tend to see who lives longer.
你现在很厉害，很恶，对不对？
Maybe you're so prideful, you're so evil, you're so wicked now.
哇，不可一世哦。
As if like, oh, there's nothing to worry about.
终究呢，你还是会死的，你知道吗？
In the end, you would still die.
对不对？
Right?
我告诉大家，各位弟兄姐妹。
And I say this, brothers and sisters.
你知道人会死啊，其实也是神给人的恩典，你知道吧？
Did you know that death is also a grace given by God to men?
你说啊，是吗？
You'd be like, ah, what?
你知道啊，你又发现到啊，这个世当世代越来越邪恶的时候啊，越来越恶，越来越大的时候，其实人的寿命是越来越短的。
Do you realize that the more wicked that the world gets, the shorter the lifespan of humans will become?
你知道为什么？这是神给人的恩典，你知道吗？
Because this is a grace from God given to humans.
你可以想象一下，各位弟兄姐妹。
Can you imagine?
如果人能够活到一万岁。
If humans can live to like 10,000 years old.
恶人还在,
and the wicked still lives.
哇, 你和我就糟糕了,
we're in very bad situation.
你没有看那些古老的王帝嘛, 对不对?
Have you watched those old dynasty kings?
万岁万岁万万岁, 对吗?
You say, live thousand and thousand and thousand of years.
10,000 years, 10,000 years. 哇, 如果人不死要一万岁的时候，我们就糟糕了。
If we can live for 10,000 years, this will be in chaos.
秦始皇现在还存在，我们就完蛋了。
The Qing dynasty king would still be here. Adolf Hitler would still be here.
那些独裁者呢？好像毛泽东，现在我们在中国都完蛋了。
And even Mao Zedong would still be alive.
你没有想过，人会死也是神的恩典。
Have you thought that death is also God's grace.
看你怎么样看死, 不一定是不好的事, 对不对?
You see, how we see death, death may not be a bad thing.
特别是我们基督徒, 我们看死亡, 我们有新的体会。
Especially for Christians, when we look at death, we have a different perspective.
我们死, 不是完了。
When we die, it's not the end.
我们只是息了在世上的那种的劳苦, 然后我们回到天家。
It is just us resting from the burdens of the world and returning to heaven in peace.
最近我看到一个的见证。
Recently, I've seen a testimony.
这个见证，这个医生他中了这个的肺炎。
So this doctor, he had a lung infection.
然后呢，他说他在这个的医院里面，他死了三次，死三次还是四次？
He said he in the hospital he died three or four times.
他真的里面呢，他昏迷的时候，呼吸不到的时候，他就见到白光。
So every time he is in a coma and he passes out, he would see this white light.
那个白光是一个人的脸的光。
Then the white light is like a face of someone.
是还有一些胡子的，他讲。
And there is a little bit of beard on the face.
每次他要过去的时候，他说你的时候还没有到，你要回去。
Every time he wants to cross to the white light, the person says, "Your time is not here. Return."
他知道这个就是他的神，就是上帝。
And he knew that this was God.
你看。 如果可以的话，可能是我要回去，我又不想在这里吧，对不对？
If we could, a lot of us would say, "Oh, we want to return to the heavens. We don't want to be here."
所以各位弟兄姐妹，来，我们来看最后的一点。
So let's look at the final point.
你看，神最终的计划是什么？
What is God's final plan?
在二章里面，在二章里面呢，二章二节不是四章四节，二章里。 二章里面呢, 神讲了两句对 Habakkuk 两句很重要很重要的话。
And in chapter 2 verse in chapter 2 God actually told Habakkuk two very important sentences.
这两节一节就在二章四节还有一节在二章十四节里面。
One is in chapter 2 verse 4 and one is in chapter 2 verse 14.
那你看哦，我们先看哦。 神对哈巴谷的讲的最两句很重要的话的第一句，我们先看二章四节。
So let's look at one of the two sentences that God told Habakkuk.
你看他说，加勒底人自高自大，心不正直，为义人因信得生。See,
the enemy is puffed up; his desires are not upright. But the righteous person will live by his faithfulness.
所以他告诉我们，他在告诉哈巴谷这句很重要的话。
God is telling Habakkuk this very important sentence.
同样也告诉我们，这个世界上只有两种的人。
He also tells us that there are only two kinds of people in this world.
两种的选择就是好像两个的对比，很大的分别。
And it goes down to the choices, the two choices with two different results.
所以带来了怎么样呢？带来了两种不同的结果。
And it brings two different results that contrast each other.
他讲的这个巴比伦人呢，他们自高自大，他们心不正直。
And he says that the Babylonians are puffed up and they're not upright.
这个是不是一个对比？
This is a contrast.
那义人怎么样呢？义人必因信得生。
So what does the righteous do? The righteous will live by his faithfulness.
这些人他们两个的选择，两种的人，一种是自高自大。 但是一种呢是信心呢是能够以神呢来到等待。
And there are two kinds of people. One is all prideful and not upright, but the other is righteous and will live by his faithfulness.
所以义人就是神的使命呢，就是今天呢，要凭信心来等待、信赖公义的神，活在信心中，必然看见神公义的彰显。Amen.
And the righteous are God's people who wait in faith, trust in God of justice, and live in faith to see God's justice and manifestation.
所以这义人必因信得生，其实呢。 这句话呢，在新约里面出现了三次。
The righteous person will live by his faithfulness. This sentence, this phrase, has appeared three times in the New Testament.
是非常关键，是重要的。
It is a key. It's a very important thing.
所以你看呢，在罗马书1章17节，还有加拉太书3章11节，还有希伯来书10章的38节和39节。
You see, in Romans chapter 1, verse 17, in the book of Galatians, in chapter 3, verse 11, and in Hebrews chapter 10, verse 38 to 39.
你看啊, 罗马书1章17节说, 因为神的义正在这福音上显明出来, 这义是本于信与自于信, 如经上所记, 义人必因信得生。
For in Romans, for in the gospel of the righteousness of God is revealed, a righteousness that is by faith from the first to last, just as it is written, the righteous will live by faith.
然后呢，加拉太书呢，没有一个人靠着律法在神面前称义，这是明显的，因为经上说，义人必因信得生。
And in Galatians chapter 3, verse 11, it says, clearly no one who relies on the law is justified before God, because the righteous will live by faith.
然后希伯来书里讲到十章，他说，只是义人必因信得生，他若退后，我心里就不喜欢他，我们却不是退后路沉沦的那些人，乃是有信心以及灵魂得救的人。
And lastly, in Hebrews chapter 10, verse 38 to 39, it says, But my righteous will live by faith, and I take no pleasure in the one who shrinks back. But we do not belong to those who shrink back and are destroyed, but to those who have faith and are saved.
各位弟兄姐妹，前面两句呢是保罗引用这个哈巴谷的这两节的经文，义人必因信得生。
See, in the first two scriptures, Paul used Habakkuk scripture in the book of Romans and Galatians.
我们是因为相信我们得的这个永生这个生命了。
And we live by righteous in faith because we believe in the eternal life.
是因为神的义。
And it is because of God's righteousness.
是在这个福音上显明出来了。
That is shown in the gospel.
凡是信主耶稣的都被称义，意思说宣告无罪了。
So those who believe in Jesus are deemed righteous and proclaimed sinless.
神已经救赎我们脱离罪的捆绑，我们得着永生的盼望了。
And God freed us from the restraints of sin and receive eternal life.
完全是凭着信心，靠着神恩典得救的。
And this is all by faith and it's all by God's saving grace.
保罗他说呢，这个义呢是本于信与自于信，意思说呢，我们这个义呢是从一开始相信，一直到末后都要相信到底。
And Paul said this faith will continue eternally from the beginning until the end that we have faith in God.
Amen. 所以希伯来书的作者就讲得很清楚了。
Even the authors of Hebrew of the book of Hebrew tells us.
他说他告诉我们呢，这个信心，无论你在任何情况之下，你都要信靠他。
And this faith is reliable in any circumstance.
你不要退后，你不要放弃。
It does not retreat. It does not forsake.
因为在任何情况里面，神没有离弃我们。
Because in any situation, God has never left us.
时候一到来的计划一定要实现的。
And as His timing comes, everything will fall into place.
无论在任何情况里面，我们都要坚持，我们要做一个选择，我们不要否认神，我们不离开神，我们不羞辱神，我们要以信心、忠心的来服侍神。
And no matter what, in any circumstance, we have to be persistent in our choice to not deny God, to not leave God, and to not humiliate God.
忠心的来服侍他, amen.
To be loyal to Him.
Amen.
A loyal servant, amen.
你知道在神的眼中呢, 他眼中只有两种人, 各位弟兄姐妹。
In God's eyes, there are only two kinds of people.
恶人和义人。
The wicked and the righteous.
两种的选择。
Two choices.
两种的选择带来两种的结果。
The two choices lead to two very different results.
恶人的结束已经定了。
The ending of the wicked has been decided.
义人呢，是因为信靠主的信实承诺呢而活着的， Amen.
And the righteous live by the faith and promise of God.
义人不是因为我们很自义，不是因为我们是罪得赦免，我们被神称为义人罢了。
And we are not righteous because of us, but we are righteous because of God.
我们本来也是罪人，也是恶人当中的。
We used to be one of the wicked and one of the sinners.
恶人是什么呢?
What is the wicked?
是不是那种十恶不作的人呢?
Is it those that commit all the crimes?
不一定。
No.
就是呢那些不以神不以这位创造主为神的人。
Not exactly, but rather those who are wicked are those that do not believe in God as the Creator.
也不能够相信这位神是有怜悯能够赦罪的神。
And those that do not believe that God can put judgment but be mercy at the same time.
也不相信他会审判的神，这个就
And the wicked do not believe that God will let judgment fall upon them. This is the wicked.
所以各位弟兄姐妹，你看两种的生活方式和态度呢，就带来了两种不同的结果。
See the two kinds of choices and the two kinds of lifestyles will bring two kinds of endings.
弟兄姐妹，义人是靠信心而得生的。
Brothers and sisters, the righteous will live by faith.
我们的信心的对象就是我们的主耶稣基督。
And our faith is Jesus Christ.
我们相信神在掌权。
And we believe that God reigns.
我们一切我们都要荣耀他为我们生命的根基。
And all we do and everything is glory to Him.
这个就是上帝对哈巴谷的第一句很重要的话。
This is the first sentence that God told Habakkuk.
第二句话是讲什么呢？
What is the second one?
很重要的话。
Also very important.
在第14节。
In verse 14,
他说呢, 认识耶和华荣耀的知识要充满遍地, 好像水充满洋海一般。
For the earth will be filled with the knowledge of the glory of the Lord, and as the waters cover the sea.
什么意思呢? 到底在讲?
What does this mean?
是讲现在的, 还是讲将来呢?
Is it talking about the present or the future?
但是我们一定要回到圣经。
We need to return to the Bible.
你看在以赛亚书11章里面讲什么呢?
In Isaiah chapter 11, what does it say?
第九节那边他讲什么?
Chapter 11 verse 9.
这个神呢再次引用这个的跟以赛亚所讲的这句话。
So God said this to Isaiah.
所以同样的也跟哈巴谷讲这句话。
Similarly, he said it to Habakkuk.
你看在以赛亚书我们就明白了。
And look at the book of Isaiah and you understand.
你说他说 在我的身上的偏住，这一切都不伤人，不害我，因为认识耶和华的知识要充满遍地，好像水充满洋海一般。
And he said, they will neither harm nor destroy on all my holy mountain, for the earth will be filled with the knowledge of the Lord as the waters cover the sea.
如果你研究以赛亚书整个11章在讲什么？
If you dig deep and you try to understand Isaiah chapter 11,
他是讲到神的国真正要实现在地上。
It talks about God's kingdom to be truly done on earth.
基督要再来，要在地上掌权。
And Christ will come again and reign on earth.
地上实现真正的公正、公平、公义。
And He will reign the earth with justice, fairness, and peace.
如同在伊甸园那种的环境里面。
Just like the Garden of Eden.
这个就是我们常常说的。 基督的国就是神的国临到了。
This is what we're talking about. We talk about the kingdom of Christ and the kingdom of God.
所以耶稣也教我们这样子的祷告。
And Jesus taught us to pray like this.
愿你的国降临。
May your will be done on earth.
愿你的旨意行在地上，如同行在天上。
May your will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
就是那一天，我们在等待的那一天。
This is the day that we're waiting for the kingdom to come.
各位弟兄姐妹，你知道那一天呢，我们是以基督在地上执掌王权，你知道吗？
And did you know that when the day comes, we will reign the earth with Christ?
你相信吗？
Do you believe that?
不是我讲的，圣经讲的 ，OK？
I didn't say this, the Bible.
你看启示录5章10节，还有3章21节。
Just look at Revelation chapter 5 verse 10 and chapter 3 verse 21.
神的话怎么样讲呢？
How does God say it?
又叫他们成为国民，做祭司归于神，在地上执掌王权。
You have made them to be a kingdom and priests to serve our God, and they will reign on the earth.
然后启示录3章21节，他说：“得胜的，我要赐他在我的宝座上与我同坐，就如我得了胜，在我的父的宝座上与他同坐一般。”
And in chapter 3, verse 21, it says, To the one who is victorious, I will give the right to sit with me on my throne, just as I was victorious and sat down with my father on his throne.
Amen.
Amen.
这里在告诉我们，虽然现在世界越是越来越邪恶。
This tells us that even though wickedness is getting worse around us,
神仍然在掌权,
God still reigns.
你相信神仍然在做更神的工作吗?
Do you believe that God is doing works within the deep?
神要在他的，先要从他的子民身上要做更神的工作,
And God, through His people, He wants to do bigger things.
最少让我们看到了，今天我们很多他的子民都是在侍奉两个的主。
But it's very common that we see that His people are serving two gods or two idols.
一方面我们侍奉我们的神,
and on one hand, we serve our God.
一方面呢,我们也侍奉这个世界,
and on the other, we serve the world.
所以各位弟兄姐妹,
so brothers and sisters,
我们要活在神的国,
we want to live in God's kingdom.
现在开始,
starting from now.
所以怪不得罗马书十四章里面有提到。
No wonder that in Romans chapter 14 it says.
他说神的国是怎么样的呢？
He said, how is God's kingdom like?
神的国是不在乎这些的吃喝。
God, in God's kingdom, it doesn't care about the, all the joy on earth.
这些吃喝不是 joy.
吃喝。
这是吃吃喝喝啊。
The desires on earth.
神的国不在乎就是这些物质的东西。
The pleasures and the materialistic things that exist on earth.
神的国是怎么样呢？神的国是有喜乐，对吗？有和平，然后还有这个的公义。
So how is God's kingdom like? God's kingdom is with joy, with peace, and with justice.
Amen.
Amen.
神在告诉我们什么呢？
What is God trying to tell us?
今天我们真的比很多基督徒他们的教，就是基督徒都是在追求在这物质方面。
And these days, a lot of the Christians actually try to seek for materialistic stuff and desires or pleasures.
我今天听到很多很多基督徒他们都讲了，或者今天呢，平安就好了。
Recently, I've heard a lot of Christians tell me, "Today, I just want peace."
他说以前啊，我就要想，哇，我要有多少，我要赚什么，我要坐什么车，我要想做什么，拥有什么。
Previously, they would say, oh, I want this kind of car, I want this kind of house, I want to do this, I want to do that.
现在他说，哎呀，平安就好了，平安就好了。
But recently, they said, I just want peace.
足够就好了。
Enough is enough.
你知道吗？是不是神在做工呢？
Is God working?
Amen.
Amen.
当然你说神为什么要这样子做工呢？
Of course, you would question God. Why would you work like this?
但是我们相信神有他的美意 ，OK?
But we believe that God has His will.
但是最重要的，今天我们要回到圣经。
But today, most importantly, we must refer to the Bible.
请问我们看到我们自己在基督里面的身份地位吗
？Can we see our identity in Christ?
我们看到我们自己未来的荣耀吗？
Can we see our glory that has yet to come?
神为我们预备的我们的荣耀的未来 ，OK?
The path of victorious life that God has prepared for us.
所以这个胜利的这个的道路呢，是凭着信心，还有上帝他的信心的承诺，对不对？他的信实的承诺。
And this path to a victorious life comes from the faith and the faithfulness of God's promise.
他的很信实的那个承诺呢，以致呢，我们要选择哪一条路呢？
And His faithfulness and His promise guides us to choose with which path we take.
所以无论什么样情形呢，什么样事情发生，我们是否会做最正确的选择呢
？And in any circumstance, have we made the right choice?
我们仍然信靠仰赖我们的神吗
？Do we look up to and rely on our God?
所以最后的一个的结语是什么呢
？So what's the final say?
你看哦，在哈巴谷呢，他就带着一个的激动的一个的祷告了。
So Habakkuk had a prayer that is filled with a lot of emotions.
其实呢，整个三章都是他一个很激动，从那个的几笔沉重的，现在是积极的一种的祷告的盼望的祷告。
And the entire book of Habakkuk, chapter 3, the whole chapter talks about how Habakkuk changes his prayer from a negative to a positive perspective.
所以呢，我很喜欢这几节的经文，三章十七节到十九节。
And I personally really like this scripture.
他最后他说，虽然无花果树不发旺，葡萄树不结果，橄榄树也不效力，田地不出粮食，圈中绝了羊，棚内也没有牛。然而我要因耶和华欢心，因救我的神喜乐。主耶和华是我的力量，他使我的脚快如母鹿的蹄，又使我稳行在高处。
In Habakkuk chapter 3, verse 17 to 19, though the fig tree does not bud, and there are no grapes on the vines, though the olive crop fails and the fields produce no food, though there are no sheep in the pen and no cattle in the stalls, yet I will rejoice in the Lord. I will be joyful in God my Savior. The sovereign Lord is my strength. He makes my feet like the feet of a deer. He enables me to tread on heights.
Amen.
Amen.
哈巴谷从开始的消沉重的心情，现在转向积极，有盼望，有动力的一个的改变。
Habakkuk changed from the negative, heavy perspective all the way to a positive emotional lead.
因为他看到神的未来的计划.
Because he saw God's future plans.
Amen.
Amen.
所以今天呢, 我们放下.
So today we let go.
我们要看到有神给我们有新的盼望, 新的方向.
And we look at that God has given us new hope and a new direction.
神的心就是要我们对他来到摆正.
God's will is for us to align our hearts to Him.
你愿意吗, 各位弟兄姐妹?
Are you willing?
如果你愿意的话, 好不好, 我们一起来祷告。
If you are, let us come to a prayer.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
我们一起的来低头祷告。
Let's bow our heads and pray.
天父, 我们感谢你。
Father in heaven, we thank you.
求你圣灵继续的在我们里面来到酝酿, 来到运行, 来到向我们继续的说话。
May your Holy Spirit continue to work within us and to talk and to speak to us.
如果弟兄姐妹, 如果我们在当中, 我们心里面, 我们有这种的消沉, 有这种的负面, 看不到有前面的道路, 但是今天呢, 好不好, 我们在神面前, 让圣灵来到动工。
Brothers and sisters, if you have this heavy heart and you feel that you cannot sense the hope or the future that is to come, let us really come forth to God and humble ourselves and pray.
让神的话语成为我们的根基。
Let God's words become our foundation.
在这个大风浪里面呢, 他的那个的话语呢, 好像那个的毛在海中的一个毛, 使我们这个船在大风浪里面能够稳定的。
And through all the seas and the storms that are happening around us, may God's words be like the anchor of our boats so that it stays rooted in where we are.
是的, 使到我们的灵魂能够有平安。
To let our soul and our spirit have peace.
主啊, 让我们的眼目能够看到你要我们所看的。
Lord, let our eyes see what you want us to see.
是的, 让我们明白你的心意。
And you let us understand your will and your heart.
是的, 主, 今天我们要聆听, 认真地来听。
And God, today we would listen attentively.
我们要用心地来聆听。
We listen attentively with our hearts.
我们明白, 知道你的心的跳动。
So that we would understand and we can hear your pulse.
你的那个脉搏的, 在这个时代里面的跳动。
And that your pulse is beating you during this generation.
使我们心里面产生对你的一个的敬畏。
And let our hearts have a fear and a respect for you.
因为呢, 你向我们启示了你的计划。
Because God, you have shown us your will and your plans.
让我们不要好像活在这个好像没有 没有主的人一样。
And let us not live like those who do not have a savior.
主啊, 谢谢你祝福我们。
Lord, we thank you and bless us.
祝福你的教会。
Bless your church.
让我们的心归向你。
And let our hearts be aligned with you.
求圣灵带领我们。
Holy Spirit, may you guide us.
每一天都带领我们。
Every day, every single day.
向我们说话。
And you speak to us.
鼓励我们。
You encourage us.
感谢赞美你。
Praise God.
奉主耶稣基督的圣名祷告。
In Jesus Christ's name we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. 神祝福你们。
God bless you all. Amen.